Hey guys, so this is Joey, or Rowan. This video is going to be entitled Sabbats, an Overview, or Sabbats, the what and why. I thought I would do a general video about Sabbats and talking a little bit about them, because obviously I've done a few videos now about Mabon, and I thought, well, some people might be watching it and are a little bit less sure about what a Sabbat is, why I celebrate them, where they come from, what they mean, if it is relevant to them. So I thought, okay, well, I will do this video before I go back and talk more about Mabon specifically. And I will talk about Mabon a little bit specifically at the end, because whilst I'm going to talk about the Sabbats in general, obviously Mabon is the next one coming, so focus on that more than discussing others in too much detail. So firstly, what is a Sabbat? What are the Sabbats? They are actually from Wicca. A lot of non-Wiccans do adopt the practice, and I started my practice within Wicca, and I take a lot of elements from Wicca now. Not all of them, but a good many, because they make sense to me. I've said before, I'm eclectic, so I sort of grab hold of anything that really appeals to me and I think really resonates with me, and put that into practice in my path. And one of the things I really loved about Wicca was the Wheel of the Year, which is what the Sabbats comprise of. There are 8 Sabbats, and at different points around the year, and they are festivals in celebration of nature, of the world around us, and what is going on at that point in nature, etc. And that is all tied in with the god and the goddess. So this is a very general way of looking at it. If you know, there is plenty of information on the internet, in books, and probably all over YouTube on the specific bits and pieces of Sabbats. I'm going to just talk generally here. So if you know, there are going to be videos about Mabon all over my channel until Mabon, so they will address that Sabbat particularly. So there are other videos if you want specifics, but I just wanted to talk in general terms, just to give people an overview. So they come from Wicca, like I said, and there are 8, and they sort of intersperse throughout the year, and it is a celebration of nature, which is, you know, a big part of what being a pagan, a witch, a Wiccan is all about. And apart from anything, it's a really wonderful celebration of different aspects of the year, and it's something I really enjoy and really love about my path and the pagan path, however you want to define yourself, is because you celebrate your religion. It's a festival, it's joyous, it's fun. There are so many activities that you can take part in that help you feel connected to the world around you and the goddess. You can do your formal rituals, which you don't have to do a formal ritual, but I do personally. That help me connect with the goddess there and in her honour. I love decorating my home and my altar for each season, and getting creative and getting, it's a connection with yourself and with the world around you and with goddess. So that's sort of starting to tap into why I celebrate them, which was my next point. Because they are festivals, because they are deeply meaningful to me. And when I first started reading about all of this sort of thing, they made a good deal of sense to me, because, for example, the autumn equinox is celebrating the onset of autumn. It's celebrating as entering the dark half of the year, which means that, you know, the nights are drawing in, the nights are longer than the day, it gets colder, the earth becomes more barren, as things, you know, as animals hibernate, as most trees lose their leaves and go into sort of a hibernation state until the new year in spring, when they all bud through. And to me, I was always very awe-inspired by nature, particularly autumn. Autumn is one of my favourites and is a really good example of how nature starts to change and changes your emotions and your tempo and however, you know, it has an effect on you. And seeing all the leaves in changing colour and the reds and the golds and the, you know, the browns, and harvest festivals were always big when I was young. I don't know if they still do them anymore, but they did when I was in primary school, and I looked forward to it. And Halloween was my favourite holiday from being a very young kid. It was my personal favourite one. And, you know, most kids may love Christmas or Yule, as it is to pagans. But for me, even as a child, Halloween. And I am not going to talk at length about Halloween because this video will go crazy. I have already slightly descended into what I lovingly term my Halloween haze, which is when everything is Halloween. I look up recipes, I look up decorations, designs, costumes, makeup, nail varnish, nail art. I've got pictures of nail art that I want to try for Halloween, fake eyelashes, decorations, glitter, things to make, things to do, games, you name it. I could spend all day, every day from now up until Halloween finding stuff. And I'm not going to do it because we've got May 1 first. So I'm going to rein it back a bit, rein it back. So I'll go back to my point. So in England, this is one of the few things I like about living in England, is we have very definite seasons. There is a definite spring, summer, autumn and winter. Summer has been a bit more of a pain in recent years, because we've had very hot early weather in Mayish. We then seem to have a really wet season in the middle of summer, and then it seems to heat up again for a little while and then go into autumn. So that's not quite summer as you know, you think of it, but there we go. But we do have very definite seasons, and I've always been very affected by those seasons. You know, for example, spring. Let's go to the other side of it. I love going for a drive with my gnome when it's spring, because we drive past all these fields and you see all the blossoms on all the little pink blossoms and purples, and it's beautiful, and the daffodils popping out, and earlier than that, snowdrops and bluebells. I always notice them. I always notice as we drive past these particular fields where they keep sheep, when they have all the lambs, and then you see a lot more rabbits about. I live in a fairly countrified area, and you know, not too far away from a city, but far enough out that I can take it all in. And it does, it affects me. I squee when I see like that, when I see bunnies and lambs, and yeah, I'm one of them. But I do love seeing nature come into blossom, into bloom. It's part of the reason why I started investigating paganism in the first place, because nature to me was more divine than anything else. And one of the famous sayings of Wiccans and witches is, nature is my church. And you know, there's a little bit of debate about whether you should be inside or outside, and to be honest, you can do whichever is optimal for you, whichever is viable for you. You know, I can't practice outside. We rent this property, the landlords live next door, there's a main road over that way. I can't. You know, I would be, there's traffic, I would be seen, there might be problems because of it. So most of my practice is indoors. That is not to say that I don't go outside and connect with nature. I do. You know, if you have your own garden, your own space, your own private place, then that you can go to, then that's great. But that's something else. So the Sabbats are sort of celebrations of the seasons and interpoints. It's like the four seasons and then the interpoints between them, and each has a relevance to the god and the goddess as well. So, for example, Lammas or Lunasar, which was the last one, is when the god sacrifices himself for the good of the oncoming year, and at Maybon we start to embrace the crone aspect of the goddess. The goddess in paganism is maiden, mother, and crone all in one, and as it passed through the year we celebrate each stage of her journey, which is a circle. She goes back and it on and on and on, ever on and on. So it goes ever on and on. So name that quote. So so at Halloween, for example, Samhain, that's the big crone time of the year, and is witch's new year. That to me makes more sense than January, and it always did, and I always connected with it. I will talk at great length about Samhain and Halloween, and after Maybon there will be many videos, and I will start off talking about my deep connection to Samhain, Halloween. But I will mention it here because it is one of the reasons I sought out the Sabbats, because I felt so connected to it already. And that is the Witch's New Year. And that to me made a lot more sense. It started in October on the onset of going into winter. And then it comes around to a full year, whereas January is pretty much dead on in the middle of winter. And that to me made less sense, but that's a personal choice. That's a personal feeling, and you know, it's difficult. It's difficult, but difficult to put into words, maybe. So, that's my next one. Was more, you know, my favourite one, which is Halloween. I love the everything about it. There is a serious side to Halloween with the honouring of your ancestors and of the dead and of spirits. Excuse me. I've said many times that I'm clairvoyant, so I have that connection already to spirit and spirits. But Halloween, when I was very, very young, and it gets to me, you know, it dials into my soul more than any other time of year. I've said to my gnome, my fiancé, I will willingly, and have willingly, had less presents for my birthday, September, and will have less presents for Yule, so we have more money saved up for Samhain Halloween. And I save up all year. It's a big thing for me. I love the decorations. I love pumpkins all glowing. I tend to be more cutesy than grim horror in my decorations. I've shown this before, but I don't care. See, this is one of my favourite decorations, and it stays on my desk all year round. The witch's cabinet, which I've shown before, which is it's a doll's house, but not really a doll's house. It's a miniature witch's cabinet, and I've shown that before. That was last year's Halloween project. That's out all year round. Now this is my Halloween tree. I've shown it before. You can see the little ghost. I've shown it before, and I'm going to show it again now. This stays on my desk all year round because I love it. And it embodies, you know, everything at glitter, and the pumpkins and the cats. Let's have a skull. Whee, look how, I mean, that is my favourite pumpkin face. And then down here, Sparkly Bats Happy Halloween cauldron. And that stays on my desk all year round. It cheers me up. And I love the Halloween trees with things hanging off them. And I go looking for them every year. And it has become part of my tradition. it cheers me up. It makes me feel better. I love everything. I don't know what it is about Halloween. A lot of witches that I have met. Now, this is an overgeneralization, first off, because I'm sure there are witches that love specific holidays for all sorts of reasons. But a lot, not all, but a lot of witches that I have met fall into one of two camps. They either love Beltane the most, or they love Samhain, Halloween, when opposite ends of the year. They love one of those the most. That's an overgeneralization, but that's just in general what I have noticed. And it does, I can't fully put into words, because it's so much of a feeling and so much of an excitement. I get revved up, I get energized, I can't put it fully into words. I get excited, I like decorating the house. For example, in the walk-in wardrobe, which we don't actually use for clothes, we use for storage, I have these great big plastic boxes that are huge, and I have three of them just from last year alone from Halloween decorations. I love it. Creepy, spooky, hilarious, fun. I don't know what it is. The only idea that I have had is maybe it's because it's a more open celebration of everything witchy. That might be it. Not maybe in its entirety, but part of it. And then you have memory and tradition and excitement and fun. The gathering of like-minded people at that time of the year. You know, it's fun. I won't go into it any more than that. I've already given into my Halloween haze a little bit more than maybe I should have. So we'll go back. Let's come back. Rein it in. Calm yourself about Halloween. It'll be here soon enough. Okay, so why celebrate the Sabbats? It honours the turning of the wheel of the year, and it sort of helps you connect with nature, but it also makes you think about how you as a person, as well as community, is affected by the changing of the seasons. It makes you more aware of nature. Say there are often recipes, for example, available on witch sites and within books that are tied into each Sabbat. So for Mayborn, there's a lot of apple-based recipes. Apple crumble, for example, apple pie. Apple is a big one at Mayborn, and that's because they're in season for. I think at least the Northern Hemisphere, I think I'm right in saying the Northern Hemisphere. In England, they're very, you know, very, very much so. Often, you sometimes, like when the holidays are reversed, you can get different books available depending on where you are in the world, because it works out differently, weather wise, temperature wise, etc. So why celebrate Mayborn? Let's stick with Mayborn. This is a time of the year that a lot of people find depressing. I don't. I love it. But for a lot of people, it can seem quite depressing. And one of the things my Nomi Gnome doesn't like very much is when he starts driving home in the dark. Because he is in has a sports car. It's not as bad as that sounds. But it's lower to the road, and he gets all the headlights flashing. So he doesn't look forward to that. He doesn't like that, and I fully understand that. But other people don't like the drawing in nights. People don't like being indoors as much if they're more outdoorsy people. And it can be quite depressing for some people. And this sort of celebration of going into the dark half of the year puts it in perspective. You need both. You need light and dark. You need balance. It gives you spells to do to burn off some negativity and pull in some positivity and find balance within yourself. And it brings a little bit of joy into each season. You know, if celebrating the Sabbats, I cook specific meals for the Sabbats for me and the gnome. And I'm trying to work out ways of being reasonably healthy with this. For Maybon, we're going to have a roast dinner. I don't know if this is a really English thing. The English roast dinner, for us, we will be having roast chicken, roast potatoes, homemade stuffing, homemade roast potatoes for that matter, veg, homemade Yorkshires, and probably other things that I've forgotten. I will record me cooking and making certain bits and pieces for the roast dinner, because you can bring your pagany, witchy, magic-y bits into cooking so easily. You use herbs and spices. We use herbs and spices all the time in magic sachets, in anointing candles, in making incenses. So you can so easily bring the magical aspects of herbs and spices into food, which has its own magic anyway. I mean, Scott Cunningham did a book called Wicker in the Kitchen, which is well worth a read, where it's all about making foods and wines and drinks and bringing some celebration in. For that, for Maybon as well, we will be having cider. We may be having cider, we may be having alcoholic ginger beer. I think probably cider for Maybon, because apple is obviously one of the big fruits of the autumn equinox. And you can have wine as well. Wine is a really good one, but I'm not a huge wine fan, and Gnome doesn't like it very much at all. So we will be having cider. All about personal choice, all about celebration, all about bringing the joy in, all about looking around you and seeing the world, thinking, how do I relate to this? How do I bring this into hearth and home? You've seen where I have been collecting autumn leaves, and I put up a spell the other day, which is about collecting autumn leaves for use in a destruction of your own inner negativity spell. It's called getting rid of your regrets and other negative things, and that's how to utilize what's available in nature. And the Sabbats are just an honoring of each of the seasons. And I mean, I do it as a solitary witch, but you, if you have more pagans around, you know, you can bring together as a group and do many, many things. And it's putting your own stamp on things. It's putting your own flavour into what you do. And a lot of people who are new get quite overwhelmed by the Sabbats and Esbats and celebrations, because they're like, oh, I need to do this right, and my ritual needs to be right, and and they're one after another. So the biggest break that you get is between Lammas, and I think it's between Lammas and which was the end of August, and my back is aching, and I look semi-naked. I'm not naked. I have a top on. So sorry, my back is aching. The biggest break, I think the biggest break you get is between the end of August and Maybon, which is a month. There might be another one that's a month long. I haven't got it all down in front of me. But they're quite soon after one another. I mean, Maybon is the end of September, and Samhain, Halloween, Carp and Quicken off. if that face is all that's down there for my pictures, I'll cry. Is the end of October, so it's a month. They're generally about a month apart-ish. Maybe a couple in some cases, which gives you a bit longer. But people get overwhelmed by that, and what I always try to say to people is, well, first and foremost, you know, don't panic. Take the Sabbats as an opportunity to put your own personal thought and stamp into these ideas. You don't have to follow everybody else's ideas, but find your own inner creativity and your own inner way of celebrating it. You don't have to do a ritual. You don't have to do a formal ritual. You could do a very basic, a very off the cuff ritual without anything written down. You know, as long as you're celebrating but the idea, you're taking in what's happening around you and celebrating that, bringing that joy in, then, you know, that's fine. And there's so many people on YouTube and, on the internet, and they give you ideas, and you can decorate and you can have fun. It's supposed to be joyous, and if you're not having fun doing it, then it's probably not for you, to be honest. But this should be something which is really fun, uplifting, and brings you back to yourself and back to the world around you, and connects you. That's what the Sabbats are to me. They are big celebration time. So I cook a specific food, I make specific candles, I decorate my altar, I write my own ritual, and then certain things that I do at certain other times of the year, depending on what time of year it is. And I've been documenting, and I will keep documenting everything it is that I do. So I'm going to stop there for now. But that was just an overview in general. So any questions or video responses, pop them down below. Love hearing from everybody. So many blessings.